Welcome to Maxill's Reality Corner, answering questions that you have brought forward. The question today, what do you do in the event of a USB logging system, recording system on a sterilizer? When do you download the USB information and you have to transfer that data anywhere? So there are no shortcuts. Nick and I can tell you that, and having practiced many years, that the view of record keeping and logging is that we have to approach it from risk management. So there's safety nets. If I have a sterilizer with a USB as my reader, indeed I'm removing the USB to go read it, and that has to happen after every single cycle, every load, every cycle. Once the information is downloaded, am I done? Wish we could say yes, but no, you're not finished. You would take that information, time, temperature, pressure, the sterilization parameters, and log that. So your log sheet is indeed your record keeping. It is your legal document. And then I will have Nicole comment more on the record keeping and retention.
Right. So from a perspective now with all the public health and IPAC guidelines, it's really important to understand that everything that needs to be logged needs to be retained for 10 years. So you have to have proof of that. So you can imagine if you've had 10 years of collection of your sterilizers, 10 years of collection of all your parameters, 10 years of sterilization, all of that is going to be binders and binders in your, for example, sterile bay. You have the ability to scan those logs. So from RCDSO, we reached out to them to ask this question. Can the originals be scanned and then shredded as long as the computer's backed up on a regular basis? Their answer from an email perspective was yes. So my 2 cents from you would be to then organize your desktop with a file folder that says, example, autoclave or midmark. And then you would scan every day or every week, depending on how busy your practice is, your log corresponding with your USB stick. So if public health came in and asked to see February 2020, for example, sterilization at 3 o'clock, you can prove that all the parameters were met in an easy organized desktop instead of having binders and binders of logs. And again, if you didn't log it from public health's perspective, it did not happen.
And indeed, that's a good way to practice from a safeguarding aspect. And think about that, you're not just doing the logging to protect the public, yourself as well as clinicians and operators, that the risk management does go two ways. Thank you for joining Maxill's Reality Corner. Hoping everybody stays safe.